I was a mortician first, and then the bodybuilding thing was more of a hobby for me.
One of these days you'll be under the covers, you'll be under the table, and you realize that all of your days are numbered, all of them 1 to 100, all of them millions. All of them.
The only other choice I ever even thought of was funeral service. It's like ministry, and you're there to help people in a moment when they need help desperately.
You cannot trade them in for
I think that things really do happen in your life to mold you or put you on the path of where you're supposed to be, and that you're meant to do that. I didn't get into the funeral industry to help deceased people, that comes with it. I got into it to help the living people get through that. And that's the need that I think that I was supposed to follow.
The story starts with my sister who had breast cancer, and the hardest part for her was going through the financial difficulty.
We were up in Sacramento, California, and she had gone through breast cancer. And she was recovering, and we went to a mall, we were walking around, and we saw the fireman calendar, cop calendar, and Katie said, I wonder if they have any mortician calendars. I said, shut up.
With his sister in mind, Ken furthered the idea with thoughts of creating that very calendar, with the intention that it would directly benefit those with cancer. The idea of CAM Cares was born.
CAM Cares, the reason that exists is because my sister did go through that treatment, and I wanted to just kind of help women that were going through that, because I saw it firsthand. Once I had the idea for the calendar, now next was like, how do you do this?
An artist was then hired to create storyboards. Once the storyboards were completed, finding the models for the calendar would be the next undertaking.
I never read the IB News before. We've been getting it for years. I mean, like, every funeral home gets that. You know, one day I actually opened one up and read through it and found the ad for that and figured, you know, what the hell, I might as well try it.
12 licensed morticians were selected and flown from across the states for a photo shoot in April of 2006.
When I got accepted for the calendar, I was pretty excited because being from a small town in Iowa, you never get opportunities like this.
Now on the surface, I know Carlos and some other people are thinking, oh, this doesn't sound very tasteful. But this calendar was put together by guys who are in the mortuary business. They're morticians.
People tend to think that we're funeral directors and embalmers are never happy, that we don't have no sense of humor. And that's quite the opposite, actually. You've got to be a little different to be in this business. You've got to have a sense of humor that's not like everyone else's. And then when you get away from the business, you're able to have a good time.
Sometimes you fall down, can't get back up. We're hiding behind skin and stoots of. How come we don't say I love you enough till it's too late? It's not too late.
I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that we see death every day of the year.
And then the media began.
Well, 12 men from across the country will pose for a calendar like none you've ever seen. And it's also one you've never thought you would.